to show you how to separate your different audio sources to individual audio tracks when recording videos, and then also how to use these individual audio tracks when editing your videos later on with Shotcut. So for the first part, we have our Open Broadcast Studio here, and these are basically the default settings. We have our simple desktop audio and our microphone, which are basically, I prefer to use just default and manage the input devices via my operating system, in this case Manjaro Linux. But nevertheless, these are basically the default settings, and all we have to do is have to go to settings, then we go to output, and then you have to change on the top here the output mode from simple to advanced, which will give you the four tabs here. And when you select recording, you just check all available six audio tracks to record. And then you just click one of those geo wheels in your audio mixer and go to advanced audio properties. And then the preferred settings, which I like to use, are that all different audio sources go to track one. So track one combines all audio. And then, for example, my desktop audio output goes to audio track number two, and the microphone goes to audio track number three. And now we go to the second part, to editing a video and using the different audio tracks in Open Shotcut. For this case, I use one of the videos I have recorded before this tutorial. So I just open a video in Shotcut. And then when I add this video as to my timeline as video track, then I can do right click and say detach audio, and then I have the detached audio track. And then I say, for example, add another audio track and add one more audio track. And then with Control C and Control V, I just duplicate the audio track. Well, this first part here, the trailing part here, we just remove. And then when I go to one of these audio tracks and say properties, I'll have this this tab, this audio tab on the top here, and here I can select the different audio tracks I have recorded. For example, for our first, we just leave it to one, which is basically all audio. For our second track, we go to properties and say it is number two, which should just be the desktop audio output. And for our track number three, we can say that this is the audio track number three, which is just the microphone output. Yeah, and now let's maybe have a look what we can do with this. First, we mute our video. We also mute the combined, let's say we don't mute the combined audio. We can select all audio tracks here, then say, let's split it here. This is voice. By the way, White Bat Audio is pretty cool because he offers no copyright music on YouTube, and all you have to do is mention him.